this oxygen, bent arm, bent hood.
TLT OCT, clear cost warning memory, verify no unexpected errors.
Fuel cells going to internal. Storm tank camera being activated at this time.
Start. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
Turning. 2-1-0. And liftoff. The final liftoff of Atlantis. Shoulders of the space shuttle. America will continue the dream.
Roger, roll, Atlantis.
Houston now controlling the flight of Atlantis. The space shuttle spreads its wings one final time for the start of a sentimental journey into history. 24 seconds into the flight, roll program complete. Atlantis now heads down, wings level on the proper alignment for its 8.5-minute ride to orbit. 4.5 million pounds of hardware and humans taking aim on the International Space Station. 40 seconds into the flight, the three liquid fuel main engines throttling back to 72% of rated performance in the bucket, reducing stress on the shuttle as it goes transonic for the final time. Engines now revving up, standing by for the throttle up call. Already 16 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 1 minute 40 seconds into the flight. Atlantis flexing its muscles one final time. Atlantis traveling almost 2,600 miles an hour, 21 miles in altitude, 24 miles downrange, standing by for solid rocket booster separation. Booster officer confirms staging a good solid rocket booster separation. Guidance now converging. The main engine steering the shuttle on a pinpoint path to its preliminary orbit. 2 minutes, 20 seconds into the flight. Atlantis already traveling 3,200 miles an hour, 35 miles in altitude, 50 miles downrange. The propulsion officer reports the orbital maneuvering system engines have ignited. Atlantis kicking on its afterburners for 1 minute, 23 seconds for the final phase of powered flight. Atlantis' three engines performing perfectly. 4 minutes, 20 seconds into the flight. Atlantis currently traveling 5,500 miles an hour, 62 miles in altitude, almost 200 miles downrange. 4 minutes of powered flight remaining. Atlantis speeding straight as an arrow toward its date with the International Space Station Sunday morning. Coming up on the 5-minute mark, Atlantis now traveling 6,500 miles an hour, 66 miles in altitude, 250 miles downrange.
Atlantis, press to ATO.
Press ATO.
That call indicating we can make minimal orbital targets in the event of an engine failure. All three engines continue to function normally. Atlantis will begin its slow roll to a heads-up position shortly. Five and a half minutes into the flight, Atlantis traveling 7,700 miles an hour, 315 miles downrange.
Atlantis, single engine, ops 3.
Single engine, ops 3.
The guidance officer here in Mission Control confirms that the computers are commanding the main engines to swivel.
Zumadosa 104.
We've rolled to a heads-up position now, providing better communications to the tracking and data relay satellite system as Atlantis heads uphill. 6 minutes, 20 seconds into the flight.
Atlantis press to MECO.
That call indicates that we can make our normal orbital cutoff targets in the event of an engine failure. However, all three main engines continue to function normally.
Nominal. Bogey, go to plus X, go to pitch.
Sound the shutdown plan. Go to the plus X, go to the pitch.
That call indicating that we will be in good shape for the orientation of Atlantis for external tank photography following main engine cutoff. Now 7 minutes into the flight. One minute, 20 seconds till main engine cutoff. Atlantis traveling 12,000 miles an hour. The main engines will soon be throttling down once again to limit the stress on the shuttle and its four crew members to that of three times the effective gravity. Atlantis currently traveling at a speed of more than 4 miles a second. 1 minute of powered flight remaining for Atlantis. Three good main engines, three good auxiliary power units, three good fuel cells. Approaching the 8 minute mark into the flight. Atlantis now traveling more than 15,000 miles an hour. Minutes, 15 seconds into the flight, standing by for main engine cutoff. That'll be followed a few seconds later by the separation of the external fuel tank. Booster officer confirms main engine cutoff. For the last time, the space shuttle's main engines have fallen silent as the shuttle slips into the final chapter of a storied 30-year adventure. Now standing by for external tank separation. Atlantis off the tank. Commander Chris Ferguson will be maneuvering Atlantis now into an orientation to enable Sandy Magnus to capture digital still imagery of the external fuel tank as it drifts away.
Ohms 1 is not required. Your preliminary Ohms 2